Okay, this is IMS core, IMS IP.
With cost, okay, this is, he already able to reading the ISOP TAUS number 60, which is normal call clearing. That's great. Call traces is already done.
The winner is actually the...
Hello guys, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. So today, this is going to be exciting video, guys. This is exciting video, guys. In order for you to go to this video, you need to watch my another two prerequisite video. First is this one, and second thing is this faulty, guys. Okay. So we already have the private offline. I just want to make sure this is offline now. Okay. I already switched off the internet, so there will be no connections to the internet. Everything will not leave from my machines. It will not go to the internet, okay? So today, I'm going to use this AI. I will just go through to the, in this case, is go to the DeepSeek first. And we will test for the next level of this AI, what I'm gonna do to analyze the trace call, guys, okay? So the first thing is, we need to prepare this one, guys. This is the faulty trace call, okay, guys? Okay, this is the faulty trace call. And if you see here, there are some port 47290, which is, this is actually decoded. This is IPv4. I'm going to put this pickup file inside of this offline personal AI here, using the DeepSeek LLM in this case. So this is safe. Hello guys, if you feel get some benefit from this channel, don't forget to subscribe, switch on the bell, and share this channel to other guys. Thank you so much. Don't use this pickup file. You put it in the SaaS or AI as a service in the website. Doesn't matter, GPT, Cloud, Grok, DeepSeek. I don't agree with that one. Okay, guys. So this is the only way, the most secure one. If you want to analyze the call trace, you must using the offline, not connected to the internet. Okay, guys. And also in the faulty trace call, in the trace call, of course, there is a mobile number, etc. Right, guys? This is the only way. Okay, guys. Rather than a lot of chatty, we will test this faulty trace call. I will let the AI of the DeepSeek to analyze this call and gain some information that I'm going to put in the prompt later. Okay, guys. Before I type some prompt here, I'm going to attach the file first. Okay, upload file. Oh, PDF doc.txt. Oh my god. Shook. Okay. Okay. Oh man, we cannot put the pickup file here, guys. You see, right? It's only PDF doc.txt. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to convert this to hexabytes. Okay, guys. How to do it? I'm going to show it to you. No, guys, I don't want to use that one. That is so silly and so tedious, right, guys? So what I'm gonna do, I'm not going to do it. If you found someone to do the silly things, just don't follow that one, guys. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just going to drag the pickup file here, guys. Okay, this is the pickup file. I will just put it here. Tara, so it's accepted. Hello guys, if you feel that get this video is very useful for you, I don't mind if you want to treat me a coffee, a cup of coffee, 2 cups, 3 cups, 100 cups, I don't mind. You just go to the link of Buy Me Coffee that I'm going to put in the link descriptions in this video, guys, or maybe this QR code. You just need to scan it. Thank you so much, guys. I already prepared the prompt. This is my prompt here. This is the Wireshark pickup NG file. As per developer instruction, the UDP port 47290 is IP4. I mean, you look my previous video, this one, guys, okay? How to get this pickup file and why the port 47290 is IP. The details are there to produce this file. So if you want to do it, you need to produce the faulty file or the faulty trace call. Follow the video first, and then you get the pickup file, and then you can start with this one, okay? So please decode it to IPv4, and then please analyze the faulty call. Long start with associated LTE, RRC, how many calls?
Okay, I will just only to delete this one. I just remember I filter this to SIP itself, and also the RTP, codec, and how many calls. Let's start this one, guys, okay?
So right now, DeepSeek is trying to do some REC. You know REC, right? Retrieval augmentations, blah, blah, blah. REC. So this is to make the AI will answer it relevantly based on the document or the trace or whatever it is, the file that we give it to them. Okay, thinking now. Okay, excellent. Okay, here we can see the RAM is 5, still okay. We have a total like a 16 gig in my laptop now. This is very cool, guys. In this pickup file,
we're not using the standard port, right? I told them to decode the 47290. Okay, let's see this one. First, this one. This is from A number to this B number. Actually, there are two transactions call in this case, but he just look at this from this to this one. Faulty caller is okay. The caller ID is this one. Okay. Suggest a multi-call scenario, possibly involving retail for multiple. Actually, no. It's just like vice versa. This call is one, and the other second call is this one. So it's not really punctual, but okay. He can, what they call this, retrieve the E party, B party. I'm okay with this. And then he said there is a IMS core is this one, but there's a special media gateway control vendor. Okay, this is IMS core IP. Okay, this one, right? This. So this is good, guys. I mean, he know that, okay, this is call from this one to this one. This is a party, B party. This is actually correct. But actually, I make some two transaction, right? To this one, A to the B, and then I transfer the B to the A, etc. But he just notice one only. And he said that, okay, this is the SIP also, this one. This is good. Okay, scrolling. Okay, good. So it say the sequence invite and then one and then this is by. Okay, good. Okay, respond. Based on the provided, I can provide partial detail for but cannot fully address or expect. So okay, fine. 7 billion parameters is good for this one, right guys? Okay, this is IMS core, IMS IP. Okay, great. Let me ask something. Maybe he can answer or not. Who disconnect the core? You can see it by look the by request send by which number. Seconds. Okay. He tell that let's finish this one first and then we will simulate so I don't confuse when blur this one. Okay. Okay, based on the analysis of the provided SIP, the call initiated by the user of this one, okay? This is evident from... Okay, so he read the second one. Okay, there is one of them is like that. And the codec itself is using the adaptive multi-rate at 1000 for video, and telephone even, and VCMA for voice. What is audio? Okay, second thing is... Call statistic total call initiated one. Actually, there are two calls. So this is not really punctual. What do you think, guys? This is okay or not? Of course, this is not yet replacing the sharp common sense of the experienced telco engineer protocol, right, guys? Okay, now what I'm gonna do? I'm going to do the same, but I'm using the Dolphin in this case. Okay, guys, let's check. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to clear all this one, clear all. If necessary, I will just delete this, delete everything, and then I have got a new chat here and I'm going to use the we can changing this one, right guys? Okay, now we are using Dolphin. Let's see if Dolphin can do the similar or more something like that. Let's see, guys. Okay, first I will just open this, I will just put it here like before, and let's see. I'm going to copy this. I don't think I have a LPRRC, if I'm not wrong, SIP, RDP, how many calls, who from who, okay, good, let's check, okay, so, same thing like DeepSeek, but I repeat it with the Dolphin. Sometimes even this is, if this is faster, no guarantee that will be more accurate than the other one, okay, this is finish of the prediction. Based on the pickup file, UDP port as well, okay. This means this part should be decoded using. Okay, good. At least he doesn't say no proven, blah, blah, blah. Okay, not denial. Analyze the first ship, establishing or different terminating real time. Provided citation, when the different ship messages like invite, trying, by, observe. These are messages. Okay, good. Now I'm going to go to the next page. This is predicting, right? So, okay, I'm going to blur this one, a party to be party. Based on this one, provided SIP, this is number, this call from this to this one. The source of IP address of this one, based on the citation 2. Address seem to be in the 2 field. Okay, good. It is difficult to identify specific IP, AMS core. Okay, based on the given. However, same information, passing the AMS core during K. Collision number of, based on the provided information, is difficult to accurately determine exact call duration. The by message indicates a call termination has occurred. Okay. Okay, let's scrolling. duration of the call, who with cost. Okay, this is he already able to reading the ISOP TAUS number 60, which is normal call clearing. That's great. Although he cannot determine which one is the one who initiate the buy request, right? Buy request in the SIP. Please populate all IP address that you found in that race. Okay, actually there are some IP that by the Dolphin is not mentioned at all. My thinking is the best one is the DeepSeek. DeepSeek is quite better than this one, okay? This is great. Okay, now call traces is already done. The winner is actually the DeepSeek in this case. Although it's not really 100% accurate, but compared with the Dolphin, okay. With Dolphin 8 billion parameter, I think that still the winner DeepSeek 7 billion parameter in this case. Okay guys, what do you think guys? Do you think this AI, this DeepSeek or another LLM can replace the telco engineer jobs? I don't think so, because it's really need common sense, everything so on. You know, like telco protocol is that the is a non-trivial things, right guys? So it's quite difficult and... But I don't know, put your own comment in the comment of this video, okay guys? I want to know what is your opinion in this case. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully this is useful for you. As always, say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.